And record it, and so I can put it on the YouTube channel soon. Okay, so just what I planned on doing today. I just put this PowerPoint on Google Classroom, so it's there. So I figured that we would review the AR/ER and IR verb endings, so they're there. I figured I don't know how you guys feel about it, but if you think that we need more practice, I can definitely find some. We'll go over the ER verb vocabulary and the IR verb vocabulary. There's not like a whole lot for either one, so I just put them on the same slide. And I figured that we'll go over like the two verb constructions that was in the book, and I think it's like kind of important, so we'll go over that. And I don't think I went over this in Spanish one, but I know Fabian didn't have me for Spanish one, so I'll go over the verb gustar too. So, and we'll work a little bit more with that tomorrow. But okay, so this is just the stuff that we've been doing. So the AR verb endings, and these are obviously in the present tense because that's all that we did. So in the yo form, we add an O to the stem. In the to form, we had an AS to the stem. And remember, these pronouns are always the same. Oh, what did I do? Okay. And then el, ella, and usted, you add an A to the end. Nosotros or nosotras, you add almost to the end. Ellos, ellas, and ustedes, you add AN to the end. So we went over that before. And then the ER verb endings, we just started going over these last week. But in the yo form, you add an O, and the O ending is the same in the AR, ER, and IR verbs. That never changes. For in the to form, you add an ES. In the el, ella, usted form, you add an E. In the nosotros and nosotras form, you add hemos, EMOS. In the ellos, ellas, and ustedes form, you add an EN. So there's that. And then the IR verb endings are almost the same thing as the ER verb endings. The only difference is in the nosotros form. So if you know if you know the endings for ER verbs, you pretty much know them for the IR verbs. But like I said, for the yo form, you add an O to the end, like always. You do that in the AR, ER, and IR. In the to form, you add an ES, just like you would for ER verbs. In the el, ella, and usted form, you add an E, just like you would in the ER verbs. The nosotros and the nosotros form is the one that is different. That one is IMOS in for IR verbs. So that's, I was actually going to put that in red. Let me do that right now. So. So there's that. And then a good way to remember the nosotros forms for the AR, ER, and IR is that for AR, it's AMOS, for ER, it's EMOS, and for IR, it's IMOS. So you just like remember like the first letter of the ending, and then you just add MOS at the end. So that should help a little bit. For ellos, ellas, and ustedes, you add an en, and that's the same as the ER verbs. So, how do you guys feel about this? Do you feel like okay with this, or do you want to do like more practice with it, or just how are you feeling about that? Because I know that we did a bunch of that on Friday, but if you guys think that you need more, we can do more. So the ER and IR verb vocabulary, this actually came from the book. So the ER is on this side, the IR is on this side. There's not as many because they only gave you regular verbs, and AR verbs are the most common, like for regular verbs, obviously, because that was like a bigger list. The ER verbs, these are all regular. I mean, there's obviously more than this, but these are just like the simple ones. And the IR verbs, these are all regular as well. Like there are irregular verbs and stuff, and we'll get into that, but we're just going to do the regular ones for now. The IR verbs have the most irregular ones, so that's just why there's less here, but I figured we'd go through these. So comer is to eat, beber is to drink, leer is to read, vender is to sell, correr is to run, aprender is to learn, creer is to believe, deber is to should or to must do something. I know that's kind of awkward, but if you say like debo que something, like that means I should do something. So I'll go over a little bit more about how that works, but I know, because I know that's kind of awkward, but that's literally what it means. So for the IR verbs, I have abrir, which is to open, escribir is to write, vivir is to live, recibir is to receive, compartir is to share, and asistir is to attend. So you can see like some of these, like recibir, you can kind of tell what that means. There's a couple of them here, but yeah, these are all regular, so none of them are irregular, so you're good. And then going over the two verb constructions, this is on page 95 in the book. I am going to take like a screenshot of like their lesson in the book and put it on Google Classroom. I just haven't gotten there yet, and I have to find the page number for these. I have it somewhere, but I have to find it. Like I said, I made this very late last night. So sometimes in Spanish, you'll have two verbs that are like right next to each other in the same phrase. So like some examples of that are, I need to go, I need to sleep, you like to read. So you see how like to need to do something and to go are both verbs. And then like right here, it says to need and to like are verbs. So to need, I need is a verb, and to sleep is a verb. You like is a verb, and to read is a verb. So they're like right next to each other. So obviously to need and to like are verbs, and so are to go, to sleep, and to read. So they're all verbs. And when you're in this situation, the first verb in the phrase will be conjugated. The second one remains in its infinitive form. And remember that the infinitive is when it ends in the AR, ER, IR. So if the verbs aren't right next to each other in the sentence, conjugate both of them. So an example is, mi esposo trabaja y cocina. So that means my husband works and cooks. And you can see that trabajar and cocinar are both conjugated because they're separated. You see what I mean? And so like I said, these verbs aren't directly next to each other, so they're both conjugated. So let me show you the page in the book. Okay. Yeah. So, okay. Yeah, so this is the page in the book. So you can see it says here, you need to study. So necesitas is you need, and to study stays in the infinitive form. Sorry, my dog is crying. Like he wants is quiere, and to travel is viajar. So quiere viajar. I like is me gusta, and to cook is cocinar. So you can see that all of the second verbs are in the infinitive form. So, and like they said here, a good pointer is that if you want to say to do something, like here you say to study, to travel, to cook, leave the verb in the infinitive. So that is actually true. And then we went over that, and don't worry about this stuff right now. But I do have some practice with this, so we can go over that. So if you wanted to say, I need to sleep, how would you say that? Remember that the verb for need is necesitar. I'll write it out. I can't type. Wow. Why can I not spell today? Okay. So if you wanted to say, I need to sleep, how would you say that? What do you think?
Oh. Yo necesito sueño. Well, yo tengo.
Yeah, that would actually be right. Let me go on here. So you could say, yeah, yo necesito And you could say sueño. That would be right. I don't know why my computer does that. Or you could say, like if you're using the two verbs, you could say yo necesito dormir. Because remember, dormir means to sleep. So either one of these would be correct.
Okay.
Yeah. So for the next one, if it says you need to study, how would you say that?
Say, yo necesito estudiar.
Yep.
That's how you say it, right?
Yeah, that would, no? I need to study. So you would say you need to study. So tú
necesitas. Oh. Tú necesitas estudiar.
Uh-huh. Yep. So you see how we conjugate the first verb, but we leave the second one alone.
Yeah.
So if you would say you need to attend, and attend is a new vocab word. If you don't remember that one, I'll go back to it. So you could say tú.
He wants. What's that say?
He wants to go. So I know that we didn't learn once because that's an irregular verb, but. So, I mean, if you wanted to put he wants to go, you could put, I know you didn't learn that one, but just an example is él quiere ir. So ir means to go, and that's another irregular verb. So I probably shouldn't have put that in there. But that's okay. But if you said él quiere ir, that means he wants to go. Okay. And then the last one is they need to eat. How would you say that?
Ellos necesitan a comer.
Yeah. Remember, it's necesitan because it's ellos.
Necesitan a comer.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Fabian, are you okay with that? Does that make sense to you? You see how, like, we conjugate the first one, and then the second one you just leave alone. You leave it in the
infinitive. Yeah.
Okay. Yeah, I mean, that stuff's not too hard, but it's kind of like a simple thing, but believe it or not, you'll, like, run across it more than you think. So, just wanted to give you that. So, I don't know if you guys knew about like when you say like me gusta or no me gusta, I wasn't sure. So they don't have a section on this in the book. I don't know why they should, but they don't. So I figured that we go over it because like they bring it up right here. So I thought I'd go through it. Yeah, and they bring it up here too. So I was like, yeah, we better just go through it. So, okay, let me go back to here. So there really isn't like a formal section in the book on this, which I don't really understand why. But so I wanted to go through it. The verb gustar is used when expressing what you like and what you don't like. Gustar is kind of like a different verb. It's just like one of those things. It only has like two different forms. So it's not like yo gusto, tú gustas. It's not like that. So if you say me gusta, that means that you like something. So if you say me gusta la comida, that means I like the food. So me gusta literally translates to me it is pleasing. That's a really weird translation, but that's literally what it means. If you say no me gusta, that means you don't like something. So, and like I said, that translates to me it is not pleasing. So if you say no me gusta la comida, that means I don't like the food. So if you want to make it negative, you just say no in front of it. So I'll probably explain this in more detail tomorrow. I don't know if you guys know it, but it's slightly different when you want to say we like, you like, he likes. We'll go through that. And gustar also changes when you're talking about more than one thing. So gusta is for one thing and gustan is more than one thing. So gustan is like the form, like the, not the formal, the plural version of it. So verbs used directly after gustar stay in their infinitive form. So I have a section on this And I only did I for now because I know that we didn't go through the other ones, but we probably will today. So if you want to say I like to sleep, how would you say that? What do you think? So remember, me gusta means I like. And then the verb for sleep is dormir. So me gusta dormir. And dormir, I don't think I gave that one to you guys as a vocabulary word yet, because that's an irregular IR verb. So, but we'll get to that eventually. But if you want to say, I like to eat, how would you say that? Maybe me gusta. And then to eat, right? So that was one of our words, comer. So me gusta comer. And then if you wanted to say, I like to read, say me gusta. And then to read is leer. I'm actually gonna change this one so we get some practice with this. So if you wanted to say, I like to go to school, which I don't think anybody says that, but that's okay. Say, me gusta. And then we didn't learn to go to school, but ir a la escuela. And then if you want to say, I don't like to learn, it would be no, me gusta. So do you see how, like, when we use me gusta and we use a verb after it, it stays in the infinitive? Does that make sense? And then when you want to say, I don't like something, you just say no in front of it. So I figured I would add in, I don't even know what to call this. I didn't think we'd have time for it today, but we do. So let's see. You wanted to say me gusta, that means I like. If you wanted to say, if you said te gusta, that means you like. And that goes with the to form, so like you, it, you informal. Does that make sense? Le gusta is he, she, you like, and that's with the usted form, because that's the formal. That's we like, and les gusta, they like, they or like you guys like. So, and these, like, things in the front here, they're, like, I think they're called, I never actually learned what they were actually called. I think that they're called, like, direct or indirect object pronouns. I don't remember. But it's just one of those weird things. So, let me just show you an example. So, you can see here, like, this is, like, supposed to be, like, an in-class type thing. So, you would, like, answer your own preferences where it says me gusta, so like you're asking yourself, like, I like. For the second one, they're saying interview your partner, so you're asking them, do you like to talk on the phone, do you? So you can see it's te gusta because they're saying you. And then for like this third section, you're saying do we like to talk on the phone, is that true or false? So you see how like it changes with like who is doing the action. Like, don't worry about this stuff too much, but I figured I'd go through it. Yeah, I think that these are direct object pronouns. I don't really know the forms, I just know how they work. So like I said, don't worry about that for 2 months right now. I would just worry about the May for now. We'll go through the, because I know that this stuff's a little bit confusing. But and then just remember that obviously with these ones, if not, I don't want. If you want to say I like the dogs, which awkward, but you would say may goose son. So you see how, like, because I'm talking about more than one thing, I'm talking about the dogs, not just one dog. It has an N at the end, because you're talking about more than one thing. And it's always like that. Okay, you're pretty quiet. I hope this kind of makes sense. But like I said, don't worry about this stuff too much. We're not going to worry about it. I did just put the PowerPoint on Google Classroom, so that is up there. I didn't put an assignment on, so I'm probably just not going to do that yet. I'm probably just going to put one on tomorrow, because that's when my Spanish 1 homework is due. So I'll go over what we're going to do tomorrow, and then I'll go over a couple things on Google Classroom. So we'll review the verb endings again, which if you guys feel like you need more practice with that, I know that there's a couple activities on Google Classroom, but do you feel like somewhat confident in that? Because if not, I will be happy to do more practice. So you guys seem pretty good with it before, but if you want me to go over it, we will. We'll review the vocabulary, which the stuff that I just started today. We'll go over the two verb constructions, which that's what we just did. I'll probably expand gustar a little bit more, which I kind of did already. And we'll start something tener plus K plus infinitive, which is like saying like you have to do something. So, but we'll worry about that. And then I'll go over the conjugation of tener. It means to have, but it's an irregular verb. So, and obviously in order to use tener plus K plus infinitive, you have to know how to conjugate tener. So, which I don't understand because they didn't put it in here. I don't really like this book for many reasons, but I don't know why they didn't put that in there. So, but yeah, so that's what we're going to do tomorrow. So I'll stop recording here. So if you guys have any questions.